Give me Play, give me Paula.
Let's go, baby, let's go. Hey, just one.
Oh, it's just one?
Come on, sexy.
All right, let's go.
Point values are triple. Top four answers on the board. Tell me the worst thing to have a dead battery when you...
A car.
A car.
Excellent. We gonna play. We get to play.
Ladies, here's the question. Tell me the worst thing to have a dead battery when you go to use it. Alisa?
Be honest, Kiki. Just be honest, baby.
Oh. Alisa?
Alicia, just be honest.
A sex toy.
Yes.
Good answer.
They used to call them massagers.
They called them massagers.
That's what I should have said. It would have been a little bit more eloquent, but that was as eloquent as I could have given it.
I know, that's right, Miss Girl. You did your very best.
I didn't ask for an explanation or nothing. Y'all just trying to talk yourself through this thing. I understood exactly what you said.
Okay. The rabbit!
Kyla, darling, tell me the worst thing to have a dead battery when you go to use it.
Your cell phone.
It is definitely going to be.
Great answer. Great answer.
Cell phone.
Great answer.
Yes. Okay, come on, Soleil. You got a baby girl. Son.
Soleil, girl, if you give me this answer right here, your team wins the game.
Okay,
oh,
okay,
my
on,
goodness. If it's not there, you're still alive. You have no strikes. Tell me the worst thing to have a dead battery when you go to use it.
Can I say something?
Yes.
I was going to say vibrator, and now that just, you know, really my...
I know. Well, you all were going to... Okay. Yeah, well, all of you were going to say that. Everybody out here was going to say that. It's
so
gone.
I'm going to go with the
remote control.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Good answer.
This is for the win. Remote. Ah! One answer left. If it's there, you win the game. Kiki, tell me the worst thing to have a dead battery when you go to use it.
Okay, a toothbrush?
They got batteries now. Think of something.
For the win, a toothbrush! If you give me this answer, Paula, your team wins the game. But if it's not there, the other team can steal and they will win the game. Paula,
yes.
Tell me the worst thing to have a dead battery when you go to use it.
My computer.
Laptop. Yeah, like a laptop.
That's a good one.
I don't know.
This is for the win. Your computer. New York, if it's there, y'all steal, y'all win the game. If it's not there, the Proud family wins the game.
And that's how it should be.
Yes. This decides the game right here. Tell me the worst thing to have a dead battery when you go to use it.
New York golden era in the building. We going with flashlights, Dad.
Oh. No. No, it ain't it.
This is for the win.
Oh, God. I'm gonna throw up.
Flashlight!
No.
It's all right, yeah.
Come on, Grupa.
It's all right. Come on, Kiki.
Come on, Kiki.
Come on.
Come on,
Kiki.
We really tried, T-Love. You're my favorite.
I need two players. Anybody want to play? Just trying to get two people right here to play the game. This is why we're here. We'll be right back. We might play Fast Money, we might not. Welcome back, Celebrity Family Feud, everybody. Team Mysterio won the game. And now it's time to play. All right, your daughter Aaliyah's off stage. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. If you can't think of something, you just say pass. You and Aaliyah together come up with 200 points. Look right there, tell everybody what you're playing for.
$25,000 for Make-A-Wish America.
All right, you ready? All right, 20 seconds on the clock, please. We asked 100 dads, which of Superman's powers would come in most handy in your life?
Protect my daughter.
Name someone who has hurt your feelings.
My wife.
Tell me the age most girls get their ears pierced.
13.
Name a breed of dog that starts with the letter C.
Pass.
Name something people do at a nightclub.
Dance.
Name a dog that starts with a C. We asked 100 dads, which of Superman's powers would come in most handy in your life? You said...
protect my daughter.
Those superpowers to protect my daughter. I've needed them too, Ray. Survey said... Name someone who has hurt your feelings. You said... Angie? Survey said... Wow. Tell me the age most girls get their ears pierced. You said 13. Survey said. Name a breed of dog that starts with the letter C. Name something people do at a nightclub. You said dance. Survey said. Boom. All right, we're in good shape, Ray. Thank you. Well, your dad did pretty good. He got 125 points. Okay. You need 75 to win.
Okay.
75 in a tough position. Gonna take a little bit of thinking, though.
Okay.
Okay? You ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's remind everybody of Ray's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. We asked 100 dads, which of Superman's powers would come in most handy in your life?
Fine.
Name someone who has hurt your feelings.
My boyfriend. My girlfriend.
Tell me the age most girls get their ears pierced.
13.
Try again.
12.
Name a breed of dog that starts with the letter C.
Pass.
Name something people do at a nightclub.
Drink.
Name a breed of dog that starts with a C.
Cocker Spaniel.
Yeah! Good job. You got this.
All right, we need 75 points. We asked 100 dads which one of Superman's powers would come in most handy in your life. Your dad said, protect my daughter. That's all he gives a damn about. Hell, he's Rey Mysterio. He gonna beat your ass, so he just... You're gonna get that anyway. You said... Flying. Survey said...
Yeah!
Flying was the number one answer. We're 26 points away. Name someone who has hurt your feelings. You said... My girlfriend. Survey said... Spouse and mate was the number one answer. We need 5 points. Tell me the age most girls get their ears pierced. You said 12. Survey said.
Woo!
12 was the number one answer. A dog that starts with a C, collie. And something people do at a nightclub, dance. Well, that's $25,000 for Make-A-Wish America. I'd like to thank Mike and Ray and their families for coming out and hanging out with us on Celebrity Family Feud. Hey, listen, everybody, I want you to stay tuned. We'll have two new teams. But Celebrity Family Feud continues. Give me Wanye. Give me Amber.
Wanye.
All right, guys, we got the top seven answers on the board. We asked 100 men, fill in the blank. Sad to say, I've never made love in a blank. Wanye.
Car.
That's a damn lie. A car. Amber.
Bed.
In the bed.
Let's play.
Sean, my man. Now we talked to 100 men, fill in the blank. Sad to say, I've never made love in a blank.
A plane.
Never made love in a plane.
Let's go.
Joe Coy. 100 men, fill in the blank. Sad to say, I've never made love in a blank.
Train.
In a train.
Good answer.
What? Bed? Bed.
Yeah.
Bed.
Yeah, bed made it, but train didn't.
But train didn't make it. It's 100 stupid people you've been asking. Way to go, Steve.
Because I don't give a damn where they get these questions from. Hey, Joe, 100 men, fill in the blank. Sad to say, I've never made love in a blank.
In a park.
In a park.
Park.
What?
What?
Bed?
I thought it was good.
Bed!
Well, that's right, bed.
Well, don't worry. This next answer could probably send you to therapy. Joseph.
Come on, Joseph.
18 years old. Joseph, we got two strikes. You got to be careful. Rough and family can steal.
Strike.
We talked to 100 men, fill in the blank. Sad to say, I've never made love in a blank.
I'm going to say store.
Good answer.
Good answer.
That might
good
be good, answer. Bro. Good answer.
In a store. Toys R Us.
What?
Let's go. All right, family, we talked to 100 men, fill in the blank. Sad to say, I've never made love in a blank.
In public.
Yeah, you have to be more specific. All of this is public.
And yet I've never made love here, Steve.
Back up off me now. All right, we gotta be specific. Feeling the sad to say I've never made love in a...
public event.
Public event! Number six.
Ah, restroom.
Five. Four.
Pool.
Pool.
Number two. Damn right, yeah. Let's get it on. Give me Sibu. Give me Nate.
The same. The exact same. You couldn't even tell the difference, could you, Steve?
Hey, Sibu, I couldn't. It looked exactly like his turn.
Thank you.
It was amazing. You was missing one revolution, but other than that, you nailed it. Yeah. All right, fellas, top seven answers on the board. If a wife hears her husband is cheating, what might be waiting for him when he returns home? Simu.
His bags.
His bags.
Woo! Good answer. Let's go, yeah.
Good answer. Let's play, man.
It's a good start. It's a good start, boy.
Let's play.
Let's play, let's play, let's play.
Jason.
Yes, sir.
If a wife hears her husband is cheating, what might be waiting for him when he returns home?
Like a big argument.
A big argument.
Okay.
Good answer.
Steven, only one strike. If a wife hears her husband's cheating, what might be waiting for him when he returns home?
Sad to say, some divorce paperwork.
Some divorce paperwork. Yes! Paperwork!
Hey! Woo! Let's go, boy.
Hey, Chris.
All right.
If a wife hears her husband's cheating, what might be waiting for him when he returns home?
Another man, Steve.
Ooh! Hey. All right, okay, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Oh, this is what we doing. I got a surprise for you. Another man. Oh. All right. We got two strikes, Chris. We got to be careful. The Chin family can steal. If a wife hears her husband's cheating, what might be waiting on him when he returns home?
An empty house, Steve.
An empty house.
Okay. Nobody's home. Let's Nobody's go. Home.
No one's there. Hey!
That's right.
Simu, two strikes. Chin okay. family can steal.
Okay.
All right, here we go. If a wife hears her husband's cheating, what might be waiting on him when he gets home?
I think a wedding ring.
Oh.
You know?
The wedding ring.
We're just gonna put that on the table there. And...
Put that on the table there. That's good. I'll be able to get some of the money back. They don't do that, Simu. They don't give the ring back.
It's fair.
I'm telling you right now, they're not giving anything back.
Let's go. Number seven.
The ring!
Oh.
All right, family. If a wife hears her husband's cheating, what might be waiting on him when he returns home, Nathan?
We're gonna go with a hitman.
Now, family, I gotta admit, I wasn't expecting this. Not from such a nice group of kids. I'm gonna have a hitman, Mr. Harvey. A hitman! Number seven. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Number five.
New box.
Four. Let's move on to question two. Come on, let's go. Give me Sophia.
Come on.
Give me Benjamin. Let's go. Top seven answers on the board. You might say about the boss who fired you, I hope he's what? Sophia.
Dead.
Dead. Dead. Number one, dead. Benjamin?
Speechless.
Speechless.
What?
Good answer.
Pass or play?
Play, 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 play.
Yeah, play.
You don't play, let's go. Frankie? You might say about the boss who fired you, I hope he's what?
Ugly.
Hope he's ugly. Dara, you might say about the boss who fired you, I hope he's what?
Regretful.
Yes.
I hope he's regretful. Matt, my man, you might say about the boss who fired you, I hope he's what?
I hope he's fired.
I hope he's fired. Yeah, you get out too. Fire him. Joshua, my brother, you might say to the boss who fired you, I hope he's what?
So far, it's not been a good track record, but I hope he's got diarrhea or digestive issues. That was a terrible answer.
I like that answer, though, man. I hope he's got diarrhea or digestive issues.
I was nervous.
I'm not even going to ask you. I'm actually going to give you a minute. Because I saw you staring at the floor, hoping that answer would pop right up out of there. Sophia, you might say about the boss who fired you, I hope he's what?
Hope he's broke.
Oh, I hope he's broke.
Good answer.
Frankie, you might say about the boss who fired you, I hope he's what?
I hope he's stupid.
I hope he's stupid.
Oh my gosh. Ooh, come on, Daniel.
Well, we got two strikes now. Lady with the wonderful hair dye.
Thank you.
If you're not careful, never have I ever can steal.
Alone.
Alone. Forever alone. Yeah. Hope you die by your damn self.
Alone. By him.
By me.
Yeah.
Alone.
Ooh, that was a great answer.
All right, guys, here's your chance. You might say about the boss who fired you, I hope he's what?
Arrested.
Arrested! Number six. Three. From playing Celebrity Family Feud. Give me Serena. Give me Mari.
Let's go.
Come on.
Oh, hey.
Do I want left or right?
Ladies, point values are triple. Top four answers on the board. If you have a dog, don't ever get a Christmas ornament that looks just like what? Mari.
A cat.
Woo! Serena.
Food.
Yeah. Pass or please.
We're gonna play, Steve.
We're gonna play.
All right, let's go.
Rodney. If you got a dog, don't ever get a Christmas ornament that looks just like what?
A Frisbee.
Nice. Yeah, good.
A Frisbee.
I was gonna say dog. You got it. It's okay.
You got it.
You have
Michelle,
a dog.
One answer left. You've got a dog. Don't ever get a Christmas ornament that looks just like what?
A mailman.
Wow. That's a smart answer.
Yeah.
Wow. Great. That's a smart answer.
That's a good answer.
A mailman for the win. Nate, we got one answer left. If you got a dog, don't ever get a Christmas ornament that looks just like what?
Another dog.
Yes.
Yes.
Good answer. There we go. Percy. Cool.
This is for the win. Another dog. Ladies and gentlemen, the man. We are sitting here with two strikes. One answer left. If it's there, Joe, Hero is all we gonna call you. Oh. Joe the Hero. If it's not there, the other team can steal and they will win the game. Joe, if you have a dog, don't ever get a Christmas ornament that looks just like what?
A car?
A what?
A car.
Oh, a car.
A car. Yeah.
Dogs chase cars.
Yes. Yes, they do.
I like that, Joe.
Yes, they do.
Rodney.
I'm telling you, Steve.
I like that.
That's Joe.
That's Joe.
Let's go, Joe.
Got that thing on.
Let's go, Joe.
Don't you get a Christmas ornament that look like no damn car in front of these damn dogs. This is for the win. A car! Joe, that was a good answer. Team, we have one answer and one answer only. If you give me that answer, your team steals and your team wins the game, flat out. But if it's not there, if you don't give me that answer, the Bachelor Nation wins the game. You got your answer? Here we go. If you have a dog, don't ever get a Christmas ornament that looks just like what?
Socks.
Socks?
Socks.
A sock.
A stinky old sock on your foot.
A stinky old sock. This determines who wins it. A sock! Number three. All right, guys, I need two players. Let's go right there. I got Nate and I got Michelle. We gonna play Fast Money right after this. Give me Joshua, give me Darren. All right, fellas, we got the top five answers on the board. Fill in the blank. Kids would be mortified if their parents took a picture of their first blank. Darren.
Haircut.
First haircut. Joshua.
I'm terrified to say nude.
First naked picture.
Now what?
Benjamin.
Spaghetti plate.
Spaghetti plate. Sophia.
Day of school.
First day of school.
Yeah, that.
Miss Lee Rodriguez.
First bath.
First bath.
Yes.
Frankie.
First missing tooth.
First missing tooth.
No.
Pass or play?
Play.
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 Let's play.
It's a hard one, okay?
Megan, this is a fill in the blank, darling. Kids would be mortified if their parents took a picture of their first blank.
Kiss?
First kiss.
That's right. That's right.
Oh, all right.
No. Ramona, it's okay. It's a game. Don't even worry about it. Take the pressure off.
Okay.
Just relax. This is a fill in the blank. Kids would be mortified if their parents took a picture of their first blank.
Their first grade report.
First grade report.
That's a good
Darren,
answer. Darren,
only one strike. Kids would be mortified if their parents took a picture of their first blank.
Date.
First date.
It's up there.
It's up there.
Let's go.
Benjamin, Mr. Spaghetti Plate.
Yeah, I don't know what I was thinking on that one.
Yeah, we're gonna put a little bit more thought into this one. Fill in the blank, Benjamin. Kids be mortified if their parents took a picture of their first blank?
Stitches.
Stitches!
Okay.
Miss Lee Rodriguez, we got two strikes now. We gotta be careful. High School Musical can steal. Kids would be mortified if their parents took a picture of their first blank.
First poo.
Yo! Yes!
That's,
yes!
Oh,
that's what I'm talking about, Lee.
Their first poo!
Let's go! Oh, gosh,
yes.
Okay,
yes.
It's my turn now.
Megan, there's only one answer left, but it's the last one. It's the toughest one.
Yeah, it is.
You got two strikes. High School Musical can steal.
Accident?
Their first accident!
Oh, rats.
Okay, it's okay.
Well, guys, I gotta tell you, this is a tough one. It's hard to get that last one. Fill in the blank. Kids will be mortified if their parents took a picture of their first blank.
We're gonna go with pimple.
Good answer! Good answer! Good answer! Good answer! Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Good answer. Their first pimple!
Come on.
Hey, that was actually a good answer. That was actually a good answer. Number five. Give me Robert. Give me Lindsay.
Do we do this?
Oh.
All right, guys, we got the top seven answers on the board, and we asked 100 women. Name a reason a woman decides to go commando. Robert.
Period.
Uh-huh. Oh, wait, what?
No. No. No underwear.
A monthly occurrence.
Tight dress.
Tight dress.
Yeah, babe. Let's get it.
Actually makes sense.
Like that.
Yeah!
Yeah! Thank you.
Pass it,
play. Play. Let's play. Let's play.
Let's
play. Let's play.
All right, we talked to 100 women. 100 women, okay? So now, name a reason a woman decides to go commando.
Like VPL, visible panty line.
VPL?
Yeah.
I've never heard of that. That's got to... VPL, visible panty line. I didn't know that. That's a good one.
Yeah.
Alex? Name a reason a woman decides to go commando.
Wedgie?
My man. Wedgie! Yeah. This is my dude right here. Wow. This is my dude. Italian stallion. Name a reason a woman decides to go commando.
When she go to the esthetician?
You know, to take care of what's down there.
Good answer.
The guy who wax, yeah.
The esthetician.
That's all right.
It's a good answer.
Sorry, it's all right.
Name a reason a woman decides to go commando.
For temperature, it's too hot.
It's too hot.
Yeah.
It's too hot.
Good answer.
Yes.
Lindsay, darling, only one strike. Give me a reason that a woman decides to go commando.
They don't have any underwear to wear.
That's good. That's good. That's good.
They don't have any underwear to wear.
Yeah. Yay!
You got this, Maya.
Only one strike, Maya. Name a reason a woman decides to go commando.
What about running away from, like, a one-night stand?
All right.
To hastily get away, and you don't have time to put them on.
Or you can't find them, you know what I mean?
Or you couldn't find them. Had to escape, get away, fleeing quickly. All right, there's two strikes. The other team can steal. Name a reason a woman decides to go commando.
I mean, I have to say this, sports and athletics.
Sports yeah, and athletics.
Love it.
Yeah. Sports.
Oh. Come on, let's get it.
Family.
Redemption.
We talked to 100 women. Name a reason a woman decides to go commando.
Because she's going to bed.
She's going to bed. Number 7.
What?
Number 6.
Yes.
Well, don't go away, y'all. We'll be right back with Celebrity Family Feud. Welcome back, Celebrity Family Feud. We got a good one, y'all. Salt and Pepper got 67. Proud Family got 54. Give me Kid. Give me Kiki.
Come on, Kid.
But with the heels on.
With the heels on. You know, she's got balance.
I'm impressed.
Oh, you better kill him with the boots, Kiki. You better let him have it. What? Point values are double. We got top 5 answers on the board. Name something you might go to and then sneak out of in the middle of it. Kiki. Yeah. Kid.
A movie.
Yes.
A movie.
That's okay, baby. That's okay. That's okay. You still fine. You still fine. You still fine. Yes. You still fine. You still fine.
I love the encouragement on this team.
You
yes.
Still fine.
You still fine, though. Yes. You still fine. You hit the buzzer first and didn't say nothing, but you still fine, though.
Yes, girl.
We gonna pass a play, kid.
We gonna play.
We gonna play this play. Hey, Play, tell me something you might go to and then sneak out of in the middle of it.
This is so wrong for my name. A date.
My man.
Ooh.
Hey, you want to name names? You want to name some names?
Play, I'm going to take that one off you. Every woman in here has done that. Went on a date, looked at him, went to the bathroom, and went straight to your car. A date. Dougie Fresh, the box man. Give me something you might go to and then sneak out of in the middle of it.
I think a party.
Yes.
A party.
Yes. Good answer. Good answer.
Good answer.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Salt, give me something you might go to and then sneak out in the middle of it.
Steve, I have been to some bad concerts.
Bam. Concert. Yes.
Oh, wow.
That was a good answer.
Wow.
Pepper, we got 2 strikes now. We got to be careful because the Proud Family can steal. Pepper, tell me something you might go to and then sneak out of in the middle of it.
A play.
No, you're done.
A play. We got 2 strikes now, kid.
All right.
You got to try something here. The Proud Family can steal.
Mm-hmm. I see them.
Name something you might go to and then sneak out of in the middle of it.
Okay, Steve, forgive me for this. My homeboy Play, please forgive me for this. Church!
You don't know how good that answer is. Church!
Come on!
Oh!
Oh, I gotta give it.
Yeah, Play, it's on you now. Play, we got one answer left. We got two strikes the Proud family can steal.
You got it, Play.
You got it.
A family reunion.
Not bad, okay. Not bad.
Right after the fight starts. That's why I quit going to mine. Family reunion.
It's our turn. We can say it now.
Okay,
class,
we
class,
have.
Class.
Oh, my goodness.
We have.
The anxiety?
A chance to steal.
Okay.
The anxiety, the stress level is high.
Come on.
Yes.
Woo! I've got to call my therapist.
Name something you might go to and sneak out of in the middle of it.
I think our answer is going to be school.
Class, baby.
Yeah.
Woo! School, class. Yes, come on.
Class.
Yes. Yes.
That was a good answer. Number five. Oh. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Bel-Air, 160. Saved by the Bell. Not on the board. Give me Hoskiri. Give me Coco.
Come on, Ring.
Ladies, point values are doubled. We've got the top five answers on the board. Here we go. Name an occasion when a woman expects her man to buy her something expensive. Coco.
Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day.
Come on, Ree, bring us home.
Anniversary.
Anniversary.
Let's go!
We're gonna play.
Hey, well, I tell you, we right on the board. We back where we need to be.
Josie, name an occasion when a woman expects a man to buy her something expensive.
Her birthday.
Her birthday. Alicia, give me an occasion when a woman expects a man to buy her something expensive.
Pregnancy or push gift?
Pregnancy push gift.
You know, it's okay.
Mario, name an occasion when a woman expects her man to buy her something expensive.
Navidad, Christmas.
Yes, sir. Christmas! Dexter, two strikes. Name an occasion when a woman expects her man to buy her something expensive.
I'm gonna go with Mother's Day because I gotta get my mama something on Mother's Day.
Mother's Day! Well, if you get this one right here, your team steals, your team wins the game. If it's not there, they're gonna get some points and the game continues.
Oh.
Name an occasion when a woman expects a man to buy her something expensive.
Engagement.
Number three.
Come on.
Come on,
that's
number
there.
Three.
Take it,
you
take
know.
It from somebody who knows.
Yeah.
That's up there.
Because that's a major purchase there. That day. Engagement. Number three. You can't buy nothing. If you cheat, there's nothing you can buy. Hey, we're gonna make a donation to your charity for hanging out with us, guys. Hope you had a good time. You were great. Hey, I need two players. I need two players. I got them right there, fellas. Right there. We'll be right back. Fast Money, right after this. Give me...